supervisor. You're gonna be my little runner. Huh? You're gonna be my runner. Hi, and welcome to the fourth annual SMSU Chopped Silver Spring Foods edition of our competition every year. This year, we threw a little twist in there. It will be more of the chopped situation. In their basket for the appetizer, they have horseradish sauce, spring green mix, and salmon. So right now they are deciding what to do with their appetizer. We're just wondering what they are planning on doing with their ingredients. Could you please explain?
Okay, we're gonna plan to kind of do seared salmon, but tuna taki style, so it's a little bit pink in the middle. We're gonna do horseradish and panko crust, and we're gonna serve it with a little salad with sesame vinaigrette.
So yeah. All right, thank you. We'll keep in touch. has gone by and cooking is going underway. We're here with team number one, and we were just wondering what you were planning on doing with your appetizer.
Yeah, I think we're going to do a pan-seared salmon on a bed of mixed spring greens with a lemon vinaigrette and a goat cheese and grapefruit segments.
Great. We'll see how that turns out. we have Amber from Silver Spring Foods, and we're going to have her talk about what she wants to see from the competition.
Well, I'm just really excited to see what they do with the products that we sent over for them to use. The fresh grain or the fresh ground horseradish actually is what they're using for the first round. So just interested in seeing how they're going to use that in their dishes.
For you, those of you that don't know, Silver Spring Foods is actually sponsoring the Chopped competition this year. They have donated a few items for the teams to use. And the appetizer, as she said, we are using the horseradish sauce. Wow. And so I'm interested to see how they can tie in those flavors. It's kind of a sharp taste, isn't it?
Yeah, very flavorful. Has an extra kick and zing to it.
How many years have you been around the kitchen and around food?
Well, I'm actually a big foodie. I started watching the Food Network probably in 2006 and have worked for Silver Spring for 3.5 years. And I do recipe innovation for them. And I also do testing the recipes and doing food photography for the company as well. So I'm in the kitchen more than one would probably think for being a marketing and public relations coordinator. That's what I do there. So.
All right. So. You're very well qualified to judge. Our next judge is Professor Samir Amin, and he is walking around the kitchen right now, and we'll try to find him. Right now, over 15 minutes has passed, and the cooking is getting really intense right now. So they only have about 10 or so more minutes of cooking time before they have to plate to be have the plating done in time. They're creating 4 plates for each of the judges. So it's kind of a large task for these groups. Team 2 right now, and they're going to explain their appetizer to us.
We're going to have a pan-seared salmon with a lemon butter sauce, Then we're going to wilt our greens with a honey and horseradish vinaigrette, and then we'll have sliced fruit as, along with our appetizer.
All right, sounds good. Professor Samir Amin, and he's had quite a long time in the culinary field. Would you mind talking about that?
Sure. Actually, I've been cooking probably since I've been 8. Went to culinary school right out of high school and found out I really loved it. After culinary school, I went to University of Nevada, Las Vegas to get my hotel degree. Worked out there in hotels and then went to Las Vegas, that's where UNLV is. Went to New Orleans, worked there for a number of years. Spent the next few years traveling around the country working in places from New York to Boston to Denver in different roles in the culinary industry. Went back and got a master's in food service management from Michigan State and decided to go on and do a PhD in food science. From there, I went to California. Had to go back out west to warm up a little bit, and worked at a company called Two Chefs on a Roll. Started as their research chef doing product development, and was there for just over 6.5 years. And when I left, I was the director of R&D, and I came to SMSU in August. And I've been here since then, having a really good time teaching. I've got a great bunch of students to teach. They're very engaged. They love, they're very passionate, and we can see that by the food that they're cooking here today. So I'm really looking forward to see what they can come up with. Really innovative bunch of students here.
Thank you, Chef. Plating has just begun in the kitchen, and it looks like it's going to be creative. Searing their salmon. You have to have a really, really hot skillet in order to create the right amount of brownness and texture for searing. Right now, Team 2 is taking their butter and spreading it over their salmon. This infuses the flavor into the salmon, and it creates a more depth to the salmon right now. And right now, they have just over 5 minutes. Will be Ben Zerbel from Schwann's Food Company. He is the sous chef there. He is unable to make it for the first round of judging, so Dr. Michael Chang will step in as his replacement until Ben gets here. Before the judging begins. So they have 3 minutes to continue plating, and a couple of them do not have their entire plates plated yet. for a little bit. Each team has plated four plates. There are three judges. One is for being chopped. The other three are for the judges to taste and evaluate. They will bring their dishes into the dining room where the judges are set up. The judges have been walking around and evaluating what the teams are doing. From there, the teams will describe what they have made for their appetizer, and then the judges will evaluate from there. The teams are ready and are going to be presenting it to the judges in just a minute. We're waiting on team two. Here they come. No, they did not go past five. Okay. Team one, would you like to explain your dish for the judges? One dish can go on the table. Mm-hmm. Amanda, would you like to explain?
Pan-seared salmon with the grapefruit.
Grapefruit, lemon, horseradish, mustard. What else did we put in?
In the pan-seared.
Oh, in the pan-seared. Sorry, the pan-seared is marinated really quick in a. Salt, pepper, basil, red flakes, lemon juice, grapefruit, olive oil. I made kind of like a vinaigrette with that real quick, and then just pan-seared it.
Okay. And then we got goat cheese, grapefruit segment, bed of spring mix with a lemon, grapefruit.
Come over here. Come here. Team two, team three, do you want to just lay it down on the table for them? And then come over here and explain your dish. Like to explain it.
Okay, we have an Asian-inspired seared salmon salad. It has a horseradish panko crust. Vinaigrette with sesame oil and fish sauce and lime, and a little bit of pecan and cranberry.
Very good. Team two, would you like to present your dish?
Here we have a peppered pan-seared salmon with a lemon garlic sauce. We have a wilted green salad with a horseradish honey vinaigrette, as well as roasted beets and apple slices, and topped with microgreens.
All righty. Judges, just some of your thoughts on the first dish.
It was nice. The salmon was cooked very well. Thought it could use a little bit more. It was a little on the tart side, maybe a touch of sweetness to offset the grapefruit. Didn't really taste the horseradish at all.
No, I didn't taste it either.
Professor Chang?
I agree. I couldn't get the horseradish taste at all, but otherwise I thought it was pretty well balanced. It could use a little more salt.
All right. You haven't started on the second dish? No? Okay. Hi, we're here with Team One right now. How did you think that round went?
Pretty well. I mean, it was kind of fun.
And for you?
Yeah, it was good. It was good. A half hour to cook up some salmon and make a salad and vinaigrette and everything.
How do you think the judges will like your dish?
Well, we went simple. I feel like simple wins. Simple as that.
Yeah, kind of like the first thing that came to mind as far as salad goes with the bag of tricks we had, so to speak, a big bag of salad. So kind of indicated to us that was kind of what was expected.
Yep.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
We're back with the judges. They just tasted Team 3's dish. What did you guys think of that?
I thought it was a little dry. I definitely could taste the horseradish in this one. But overall, the dish could use a little more seasoning and a little more dressing.
Okay. How about you, Amber? I'm sorry. Yes, I did. Ask them.
I could use a little more dressing on the salad as well, on the lettuce. And I did get some horseradish flavor in this one. It was good.
All right. Chef Samir.
I thought the salad was a little dry. Couldn't really get to the cranberries until you got through the salad. Salmon was a little overcooked for me.
All righty. And then I'll be back with dish number 3 or team number 2. How did you feel about tea number two's dish?
I think it looked nice. The beets weren't really roasted. They were kind of seemed more like a saute. They were still too crunchy. I don't really think wilting spring mix really brings out anything. And the salmon, I was expecting a little bit more horseradish. I get a lot of black pepper, and it was a little bit overcooked for my taste.
I could taste a little horseradish in this one, but more pepper, the same as Samir or Dr. Min. The greens just seemed a little oily to me, so they could have done without as much oil as they had on there.
I agree. It was a little too oily. The plate was too big for the appetizer. The fish, my salmon was overcooked, so you could have taken off the heat good 2 minutes earlier.
All right, thank you. We'll go back to the kitchen now, where we're going to bring out the second basket for the entree. We're in the kitchen now, where we're waiting on the baskets for the entree round. So what did you guys think about your presentation?
I thought it looked really good. I think we made it all come together real well.
Very good. All right. Here are the baskets. In the baskets this time, there will be pork chop, carrots, white radish, and some dates. So it's quite an interesting basket, different elements of flavor that they'll have to try to combine into one. And then the Silver Spring food donation in this round is whole grain mustard. Team three is chopping up the dates. What are you planning on doing with the dates?
We're gonna make a chutney with the dates for the pork chop.
She said she was going to make a chutney for the pork chops. If you don't know, it's kind of a spicy salad. Team number two is working on melon balling their potatoes. What are you planning on doing with the potatoes?
The potatoes are going to go with leeks and garlic. It's going to be kind of savory.
As a bed or as a...
I mean, as the starch for the entree.
All right. And what are you planning on doing with the pork chops?
We're going to roast them first, probably, and then finish them off with a nice sear.
Okay. So they're going to stick them in the oven and then get it nice and golden brown so it has quite a depth of flavor in their entree. And Amanda, what are you doing with those bell peppers?
I'm still figuring out right now. Yeah.
All right. Yellow bell peppers have a milder taste. They're kind of sweeter than normal green bell peppers. So that will go interesting with the radish, which is kind of a spicier, or it has a little bit of a kick to the vegetable. Chopped. There are four teams, and after each round, a team is eliminated. Unfortunately, we only have three teams this year, so they will complete their appetizer round, which they have just done, and then they will complete their entree round, and after the entree round, then one team will be chopped. And then the final two teams will compete in the dessert round to find out who is the winner. The teams have 45 minutes to complete their entree. Right now, about 10 minutes has elapsed. They are in the preparation stages. I see team number two is also chopping up their dates. Do you know what you're going to do with your dates right now?
We're going to macerate them and then use them for a sauce.
All right. So the sauce will probably go over the pork chops, I'm assuming. All right. That will be interesting flavors. The dates are dehydrated, and they have a little bit of a caramelized texture to them. contestants right now are in their in the kitchen working on their entree. So we're just going to go over the appetizer again and see what the judges thought more in-depthly about the appetizers.
Well, I thought Team One had a really nice presentation. I like that they used the grapefruit and also the contrast with the cheese. The salmon was cooked perfectly. There was good balance of flavor, except I couldn't taste the horseradish.
I agree with you. I could not taste the horseradish either. And the salmon was cooked good on this. I thought that salt and pepper would have been a good addition. And I liked the grapefruit on the greens as well.
I enjoyed this dish. The presentation was nice. It wasn't anything overly thrilling, but it was executed well. I liked the grapefruit. Thought maybe a little bit of sweetness in there to offset the tartness of the grapefruit would have been nice. Definitely salt and pepper on the greens. The goat cheese, it was a nice addition, but I really didn't see a reason why we had the goat cheese in there, other than to put some sort of a cheese in. And definitely, like I said, salt and pepper, more horseradish too. The horseradish was non-existent in my mind. Thank you. Okay, so this is team number two. I thought the presentation was nice. It looked like they took a little bit more time and thought on how to present it. Though I probably would have gone down on the size on the plate. It looks lost. Probably could have pulled it off if you had a different colored plate rather than white. Didn't really care for all the liquid that was kind of spilling out around it either. Kind of made the plate look a little bit messy. The roasted beets, didn't really get any roasted flavor off of them. Tasted more like they were just lightly sauteed or lightly roasted. They still had too much of a crunch for me. The salmon was a little overcooked, and the greens, I didn't see a real use for wilting them. I thought with spring mix, they kind of lost any uniqueness or crunch factor they might have had from it. It didn't really bring out any other flavors. Also, I thought the dish overall was a slight bit oily.
I agree with the fact that the presentation was really nice. It was compact and looked good. The plate size did need to come down a little bit. It was a little big for me. My salmon was cooked good, but I could not taste very much horseradish in this one again. I was having a problem with more pepper than tasting horseradish.
I felt that too. Pepper kind of overpowered everything.
Yes. Yeah, it was a lot. And the greens for me were really oily. It was too much oil, so the balance was kind of off for me on that.
I agree. Overall, I think the plate presentation wasn't too bad. It's just it left an oily taste on my mouth when I was eating it. When I had the slice of apple with it, it seemed to help cut down on the oil on it. But again, I couldn't get past the overdoneness on my salmon. I got a little bit of horseradish off of it, a little more than the previous plate did. And the wilting of the greens didn't really do anything for me either.
Okay, so we've got team three, the panko on the outside of the salmon. My salmon was undercooked on this one in the middle. The end of it was not, so it wasn't consistently cooked all the way through. I can taste the horseradish more on this plate than either of the two previous dishes. And from going from having too much vinaigrette on the last plate, this one didn't have enough for me. It seemed kind of dry. The presentation was okay for me on this one, but the salad just, it seemed kind of like it was thrown together and just, you know, there's walnuts and craisins and not very much dressing. So I thought it could have been executed a little better.
I agree with Amber. I thought the salad definitely needed dressing. It was dry. It needed salt and pepper. When I got my plate, the cranberries and the pecans were all sitting at the bottom, so I really didn't see them. And looking at them, I thought the pecans were chopped too much. They were too fine. If I was going to do pecans on this plate, I probably would have chopped them and put them in the breadcrumb. Thought the breading was a little too thick on the salmon. It kind of took away from the salmon itself. Probably would have also liked to see maybe the whole salmon drizzled with a little bit of the dressing would have been nice.
Well, I agree. I think the plate itself, you know, they had tried some innovative methods with it, especially with the breading and the salmon, which initially when I saw it in the kitchen, I thought it was a corn cake. Turns out it was salmon. So that was a surprise. I did get a good horseradish taste from it. But I agree the overall presentation was not too bad, except it was really dry. It just needed more dressing on it. It had a pretty good balance to me between the crunch on the salmon and when I did find the dressing, and then it added a little bit of texture too.
Now we'll head back into the kitchen and see how the teams are doing. With team number three right now. How is your dish shaping up?
Really good, Hannah. We're going to make seared pork with date chutney, roasted carrots, and kind of a creamy pasta side, Moroccan inspired.
All right. What do you think of the ingredients in the basket?
The kind of weird. I've never worked with dates or white radishes or rainbow carrots, so it was kind of a shocker, but I think we're doing fine.
All right. Thank you. Now we'll move on to team number two and see what they have cooking up. How is your dish shaping up?
It's going pretty good. We got a lot of good flavors, a lot of good shapes going on, so should be a lot of different textures, which will be nice.
All right. How did you feel when you saw the ingredients in the dish?
I was pretty surprised, especially with these mixed carrots right here. But all in all, it's going pretty well.
All right. Have you ever worked with rainbow carrots before?
I have not worked with rainbow carrots before. First time for everything, though.
And right now you are sauteing them in a little bit of butter?
Yep. And after that, we're going to puree them with jalapenos.
All right. So they're going to puree it and have a spicy carrot kind of a sauce for their pork chop. Let's see what team number one is up to. Amanda has cut up quite a lot of bell peppers. Amanda, how is it going right now?
Good. So far I'm doing a vegetable medley.
Vegetable medley, which is basically a bunch of vegetables sauteed in a dish or cooked down some way to make the hard root vegetables of the horseradish and the carrots into a more palatable, soft texture.
Sear them up and throw them in the high oven for a little bit.
What's your plan for the pork?
So far we got, we're going to sear them off with just salt and pepper, and then we're going to make a date, stone ground mustard, apple, and stout beer sauce that we're going to drizzle on top.
So it sounds like all three teams are going to make a date into some sort of a sweet sauce for their pork. And right now, about 25 minutes have elapsed in their cooking time. And so it's going underway. They have just over 20 minutes. Rubbing, having a dry rub for their pork chop. They have deboned their pork chop. The bone has a lot of flavor in it, so he's adding more flavor into the meat to make up for the lack of bone marrow. That. Is attempting to roll their radish. I'm not entirely sure what they're planning on doing with the rolled radish. Maybe Levi can tell us about it.
We're making like a faux cannoli with a roasted carrot puree that's going to be filled in the middle. These are going to be fried shells.
Oh, so they're going to fry their radish in and then make a cannoli. If you guys don't know what a cannoli is, it is a fried pastry with like a ricotta cheese filling inside. So they're gonna change the ricotta into a carrot puree to add a different flavor to a traditional cannoli. We are with Team 1 right now, and I have a question for them. How are you planning on using the Silver Spring Food whole grain mustard in your dish?
We're going to make a sauce with the pork.
So it's going to go on top of the pork.
Yep.
All right. With Team 2 right now. How are you planning on using the whole grain mustard in your dish?
Using it in our puree, as well as a pan gravy that's for the pork.
So it's going to go into your cannoli type radish.
Cannoli. Yeah.
Alrighty, as long as a sauce on the side. Number 3, how are you planning on using your Silver Spring Foods whole grain mustard in your dish?
We put it on the outside of the pork, so it'll make a nice little crust, and then we put a little bit in our chutney to add a little tang.
All right. So they're going to use it in multiple areas, just like team number two. Interesting. They're going to use it in multiple areas in their dish, just like team number two. To try to make their puree for their radish cannoli. And right now they have just over 15 minutes to complete their entree. Right now,
I am working on the carrot and jalapeno puree.
So he just added some heavy whipping cream. This will add liquid to the puree, as long as making it more of a fattier flavor or a coating of the tongue more for the dish. It seems that team number two has added a mirepoix with her carrots and apples to make a sweeter sauce for the pork. I'm assuming that's for the pork. Mirepoix is just basically onions, celery, carrots, and some pepper to flavor the stock of something. She's using chicken stock right now. It's very classic. It's very French style of cooking. What you guys just saw was team number two working on their gravy. It seems that he has gotten the blender to make more noise, which sounded like it was making progress, but it still seems a little thick. Tasting it right now to see if they needed to add anything or change it. Apparently it is good. They like the flavor. And so they will put that in a plastic bag and pipe it once the cannolis or the radish is done frying. The kitchen is heating up with just 10 minutes to go before judging. Everything seems to be coming together nicely. Let's see what Renee is doing over here. What are you doing right now, Renee?
Well, I just caramelized the apples a little bit with some butter and some other spices, and I did a mixture with it. That's how I'm using the whole grain mustard. I'm doing a sauce with the dates, with the mustard, with the apples, with butter, with that stout that we have. I mean, it should turn out pretty well.
Find it very interesting that all three groups used apples in their entree. Apples and pork go very well together. Pork has a milder flavor, and the apples have a sweet flavor that will cut through and pair very nicely with the pork chop. I'm with my LLPA, Katie Langle. She helped organize this event with me, along with the Dr. Chang. And Katie has something to say to the audience.
Hi, Erin. I know you're at home and you're watching us, and I just wanted to give you a shout out. And good luck to the teams today. I'm really proud of everyone here. They're doing an awesome job. It's really inspirational to see them like do all this under like a time limit like this. It's just really awesome. And it really is like, this is what we're meant to do in our life. So it's really cool to see them doing it and expressing their love for cooking. That's it.
Thank you, Katie. And right now they have just over 5 minutes to go to have plating and to judge. Right there you saw team number three pickling their radishes in a quick pickle type of a sauce. What went into that sauce?
Just vinegar. Just simple vinegar and champagne vinegar.
So the acidity should help make that pickle flavor in your dish. What you are seeing right now is the final plating of each team's entree. It seems that team number one has made a mashed potatoes with chives. They're just plating it on square plates, which will give it a different look to the plates that might help differentiate their dish from the others. Our third judge, Ben, has just arrived, and we'll do a quick interview with him before we start with the judging of the competition. I'm here with our judge, Ben, who has just arrived. You want to give us a little bit about yourself?
Well, I spent about 3 years in culinary school while working at the American Club in Kohler, Wisconsin. I was there for about 4 years before I transferred for a food science degree, and I'm currently with Schwann's Food Company as a corporate chef.
All right. Final preparation and plating for all of the teams are going underway right now, and there's about a minute left, and we'll see what they're doing in the kitchen right now. Put your hands up. The plating has completed. Let's bring it out to the judges and see what they have to say. All right, plating has been presented to the judges. I'm here with team number one. You want to face the camera and show you your dish. Can you please describe your dish to us?
Okay, we got a salt and peppered pork chop, oven roasted, and then mashed potato with chives, and a stout apple date sauce, and then a vegetable medley with white parsnips and yellow peppers and carrots.
Do you want to have anything to add to that?
Yes, in the sauce we also use the whole grain mustard. So it's a reduction of whole grain mustard, stout, butter, garlic, dates, salt, pepper. That's pretty much it.
All right. Team number two, do you want to come describe your dish, please?
All right. Today we made a pan-seared pork chop with a pan gravy, and the gravy has the stone ground mustard in it. Then we have potato pearls, and then a faux cannoli made with a roasted garlic or roasted wild carrot puree in the middle, and then it's topped with macerated dates, and there's also the stone ground mustard within here. So,
all right, thank you. Team number three, would you like to explain your dish for us?
Good evening. So today we have a sear pork chop with mustard grain on it to use a dry rub, and also put some Moroccan spice to the pork chop too. And the side we have a saute a variety of carrots, and then we put some honey to enhance the glazing factor on it. And the red one is actually the pickling watermelon radish. So we pickle it to give the sourness and the flavor. And this is actually is a pasta rice, and we use it. I put yogurt to enhance the ooziness of flavor, resemble risotto. So the pasta rice is using American spice to it and enhance the flavor of it.
Thank you. Contestants, you can go back to the kitchen now and clean up. At the end of this round, we will chop a team so that there will be only two teams competing for the dessert round. I'm here with team number three. What made you join the competition this year?
Well, we did the competition last year, and we competed against LaShawn and Levi, who their teammate was also Brando. And we beat them out, but they thought it was unfair, so we decided to just show them up again.
For those of you that don't know, they're going against team number two again this year, and they kind of have a friendly rivalry between the two. They want to win again, right? Again. So what made you join the competition again?
For me, it's actually the same idea of like beating the team number two, the boost battle. So for this time, it's actually we bring out our ace game to bring out different kind of country flavor. So for the first call, the appetizer, we try to go for much more Asian influence. The second course, we go to Mediterranean to give it all the color, all the spices to enhance the product flavor.
All right. And you two are both in the culinology or hospitality major, correct?
We're both culinology majors.
Exciting. And what year are you guys?
Junior.
Senior.
Senior, so you'll be graduating. This is your last Chopped that you can participate in, but maybe again next year for Janelle. We'll go see what the judges have to say about the entrees. Hi, I'm here with team number two. Team number three told us you kind of have a rivalry from last year. You guys want to talk about how that all came apart?
Last year we kind of got hosed a little bit because we had a cut of meat that we were supposed to have a different one, and we ended up having a much larger one, so we couldn't actually cook it all the way through. It's not actually possible. So I don't know. We had a lot of problems in the last one, but I still think we did a pretty strong job. So
yeah, they're our closest competition right now. We met them last year, of course, like you said, and came down to the wire for us two teams. Just a few points sort of differentiated us from the finals.
So you really want to win this year and stick it to them, kind of to say, all right. Is that your main motivation to doing Chopped this year?
I don't know. I mean, we just came out here to make sexy food, honestly, and I think that's about the extent of it.
Yeah, I'm just kind of here to challenge myself, you know, try Chopped before I try to actually go on the show.
We asked you before. I'm sorry, I just cut you off.
Well, I'm kind of new to the team this year, so I'm just here to do my best.
So last round you had some interesting items in your basket. How did you guys came up with your final dessert or entree?
Not entirely sure. Just kind of a collaboration of ideas. We all worked together on that, you know, brainstormed a little bit, tried something different, went out on a limb a little bit.
Anything else? Who came up with the cannoli idea?
I came up with that because I didn't really know how else to use the radishes, so we just went for it. I figured we'd give it a shot. We made it with the puree, and I said, well, might as well, if we have a puree, go ahead and give it a shot, so.
All right. Anything to add?
No, none to add.
All right. So, all right. We'll see what the judges have to say about this. They are deciding on who they will be chopping this round, and then two teams, again, like I said before, will be competing in the dessert round, and we'll see who those teams are. The judges are still deciding on what they think about each dish. How important is sanitation in this competition?
Oh, super important. Very important, yeah.
So what are you guys kind of doing to make sure that you guys are sanitary and that nothing's being cross-contaminated?
Definitely wearing gloves on, like, things that we're touching that'll go straight out to the judges, for sure.
Different boards for different things. Each board has a use, and we're trying to use each board as it goes. We also have tasting spoons pretty much all around us so that we don't have to dip. I have a bad habit of that. I think I've controlled it pretty well. I don't know, sanitizing buckets underneath, trying to keep our area clean as we go. I mean, trying to do as cleanly as we can.
While the judges are deliberating on the dishes right now, the teams around here are cleaning up and making sure that their station is clean and sanitary and ready to go. Cross contamination is really kind of easy to do in the restaurant industry, but it's very easy to prevent also. They have sanitizing buckets. They wash everything, clean everything, and make sure that the areas are safe and clean so that we don't cause a foodborne illness and someone gets sick and then it's bad from there. So thank you for your time on that subject. The judges are finishing up with their deliberation right now. Just again, a reminder of what was in the basket. The contestants had pork chop. They also had a white radish. They also had Spring Foods rendition of a whole grain mustard. And well, they did use a whole grain mustard in their sauce. And then also they had dates. So each contestant or each team had to use all four of those ingredients in the dish to create a palatable and hopefully delicious entree for the judges this year. They are tallying up the scores right now to see who will be on the chopping block. We will also get feedback from them about each dish and what they thought about how the team's interpretation of each ingredient was. We are back with the judges, and they will give feedback on each of the dishes. Let's start out with Team One's dish, which we'll start with one.
Okay, Team One. Team One did the pan roasted the pork chop. Team One did the pork chop with the roasted with the mashed potatoes. The presentation was nice. I felt maybe it was a little lacking in color. Tended to be more brown and white on there. Maybe if you didn't roast the hailstone radish as much, we could have kept some of that color in there. Let's see what else. The potatoes. I thought the potatoes were a little dry. Could use some more fat in there. A little bit less salt, but that just might be me. Veg were good, well balanced in flavor. Texture, as I said, the potatoes were a little dry. I liked the texture on the vegetables. The pork chop was cooked well. I thought it was perfect. Overall, I liked it. I thought the only comment I might have is on your chutney. Maybe a little bit of acid in there would have been nice. Overall, I enjoyed it.
I just want to say the presentation on all three plates for me was excellent. In comparison to the first round, they were good, but this one I think was better. Is that better? Okay. So good job, teams, on your presentation. The chutney I really liked. I thought it was good. You could see the whole grain mustard in there, which I think just gives it an element of surprise when you get the little seeds sometimes. I thought that the potatoes were dry as well. The veggies had a good crunch to them. They weren't overcooked. The pork chop was evenly cooked as well and had good flavor with the chutney. And I think that was it for me on that.
So not having seen the first round, I also thought the presentation was very good on all of them. So whether it was for them, it was the difference of the first round to the second round, or if it was just coming in with fresh eyes, I thought the presentation was great. I agreed that the potatoes were dry. The vegetables were cooked well. I could have also used a little more salt pretty much across the board, across the dish. The chutney was very good. It could have benefited from it, some acid, but it was really good. And I thought your flavors overall worked really well together.
I'll go. Team two. Okay. First, I will tell you that the pork chop was cooked very good. Mine was. And the pan gravy underneath that, it was more like a paste to me. It wasn't a gravy that I was thinking that it was going to be. I was surprised by the carrot puree with the jalapeno that was in it. It was a little bit too spicy for me. But I don't know, and the potatoes didn't have any salt and pepper on them, and the flavor and the balance of this plate was just a little bit off for me, but the presentation was good on it. Thank you.
I thought the plate looked nice. The plate might have been slightly too big for the presentation, I thought. Let's see. The potatoes were bland. I thought if you did the potatoes, I would have liked to have seen you maybe pan saute them back a little bit, get a little bit of color on them. The carrot puree, my mind was too spicy, and even in the cannoli, it was a nice idea, but you lost any flavor of the carrot with the jalapeno in there. Also, I mean, the carrots are such a beautiful color contrast, thought it was a shame to puree them up. You lost any of the purple colors that you had in there. The pork chop was cooked perfectly for me. I like it still, I like it medium. Okay, and the gravy was basically a paste. It took me a while to figure out what it was. Thank you.
I'm pretty much on track with the first two judges here. This one kind of missed the mark for me. My pork chop was cooked very well, so you did a really good job with that. But the gravy just really was not what the dish needed. It needed a looser gravy, needed you to add the moisture to it, it needed the flavor from the whole grain mustard, and you bound it all up so tight that it was almost like a glue. It just wasn't what it needed to be. And the carrots with the jalapeno, I like spice, but there was just no depth of flavor to it. It was just jalapenos and carrots. It lacked any kind of balance to it. And again, your potatoes were, they were good. I mean, it was a good idea. They're attractive, but they needed some salt, and they needed some kind of flavor added to it to really round them out. Go ahead. Oh, okay. Team three, you're the only team that took the bone out of the pork chop. I like the bone. I would have left it in. I think it's a good presentation. But overall, I thought your presentation was very good. Your carrots were good flavored. I liked the honey on them, but they could have cooked just a little bit longer for me. The pickles were, I just don't think you had time to make pickles. The vinegar on there was really strong, and it was almost hard to eat them. But your chutney was excellent. The chutney on top of there was very good. I think that's all I had.
I'm going to agree with everything that you said, and the chutney was very good as well, but the orzo was also, it had no flavor for me. I don't know if there wasn't any salt or pepper in there or anything, but it was just kind of bland for me, and it seemed a little bit overcooked, I think we decided, but overall it was a good plate. Thank you.
For me, the plate looked nice. I thought you had way too much orzo on there for the plate. It's just too much. The pickles, it just tasted like straight vinegar. The carrots were good. Maybe a little bit longer on the cook would have been nice. I thought the pork chop, mine was a little overdone. It was a little dry. I think if you'd left the bone in there, you probably wouldn't have run the risk of overcooking it. The chutney I really liked. The only thing I would have said with the chutney is maybe a touch of acid. You know, and maybe that could have come from your pickle being finely diced or Brunoise mixed in that. But that's what I've got. Thank you.
And the judges have also decided on which group will be chopped, and this group will be group number 2 is chopped. Thank you for participating. The other two groups, can you go into the kitchen and we'll get started on the dessert round. Thank you. Hi, I'm back in the kitchen, and in the basket that they have this time is Pepperdew mustard from Silver Spring Foods Company. They have frozen peaches and a butternut squash. They have 30 minutes to complete the dish, so they have about until 7:40 to get everything plated out and have the judges to deliberate again on their last dish. We will interview team number 2 as they were just chopped. So this round seems very interesting, and we'll see what these two teams have in store. Do you guys have a quick idea of what you want to do for your dessert?
Yeah, we have a pretty good idea. So far we're thinking about doing some quick little squash pancakes, and then pancakes with squash in them, and then some apple peach mango caramel kind of sauce, and then maybe some cream cheese heavy cream topping.
All right, sounds good. Let's see what team number 3 has in store. I see some flame. I wonder what they're going on. Do you guys have a rough estimate of what you want to do?
Yeah, talking about you now.
Talking about it right now. I've interrupted them. I am sorry. Okay. I see that you are going to be boiling your squash to hopefully make it soft.
So first of all, we're going to boil the squash to make it soft. And then I'm going to add, after boiling it soft, to blend in the white mix. And then we're going to use the frozen peach as ice. Instead of using ice, we're going to use frozen peach to cool down the mixture. And then we're going to use some acid, some mango, or to make it to a sorbet or a gelato type of dessert to them. And then we're going to use a wine, a red wine, to enhance the flavor, to give them synergize to each other.
All right, thank you. I'll let you get back to your dessert right now. I am here with the judges right now, and they are going to tell us why they chose to chop group number two and why they liked the other group's dishes a little bit more, if not about the dish.
For me, the reason I chose group two, it had to do mainly with the entree. I thought, like I said in my comments, the carrots, I thought it was a waste to take those rainbow carrots and puree them up. The potatoes were bland. And the main thing that really got me was the pan gravy. It had too much starch in it. It was thick and gloppy. Actually, it wasn't even gloppy. It was just a paste. So I really didn't feel that did it any justice.
Gravy did it for me. That's all. I mean, it kind of just wrecked the whole rest of the dish for me. So that was it.
Yeah, the gravy and the carrots just didn't show the technique that it needed to show to move on.
Thank you, judges. From what you see going on in the kitchen right now, I hope it's a good mixture of the desserts, would you say?
Yes, we're all looking forward to seeing what they're going to do. I mean, this looks really interesting. See how they're going to incorporate the butternut squash and mango. I'm seeing a lot of mango in there and citrus. Really excited to see what they're going to do with that peppadew.
The peppadew mustard is probably one of our most unique items that we have. It's a sweet heat. So it's going to be very interesting to see what flavors they can incorporate into a recipe with that and make happen flavor-wise. So I'm interested in seeing what they do with it.
I'm also interested to see how they use the mustard. I think there's a lot of different ways to incorporate it here, and I think the way they incorporate it with their dish is going to make a difference as to how it shines through the dish. So I'm excited to see what they do with it.
Thank you, and let's see what the contestants are saying about their dish right now. So team one, what are you doing right now?
Right now, I'm getting my dry ingredients together for this pancake that I'm gonna make. I'm kind of winging it, but I guess it's gonna have to do.
All right, and your team is also using mangoes, correct? Sorry? Your team is using mangoes.
Yes, we are using mangoes, peaches, apples.
Mangoes, peaches, apples.
sugar, Philly cream cheese, the squash. I mean, it's going to be interesting to see how this thing comes out. But
yes. Right now they are softening up both their apples, peaches, and mango in a saute dish over here. And they are boiling their squash as well. Let's see what team number three is up to. Team number three is chopping up some mint leaves. Obviously going to go into their cold dessert. What else did you guys decide on your dessert?
We're going to attempt a crepe, and then we're going to fill it with our cool mixture of mango, banana, mascarpone cheese, and butternut squash.
So they are also using mangoes in their dish to create different flavors and profiles of the dish. Team number one is also roasting a few pecans in the oven. This will give it a more nuttier taste to the pecans and the nut. Right now, Renee is whisking together his pancake batter, which the group decided to add in squash to that batter as well. And that's where their squash in the dish will remain. How are you planning on using the Pepperdew mustard?
So far, we're thinking about incorporating into our cream cheese yogurt topping. Gonna put a little bit in there and see how it is.
All right, great. I see number three is also using their Pepperdew mustard. And how are you using yours?
We're mixing it with our mango and mint mixture that's going to go inside of our crepe.
So it's going to be a filling to their crepe mixture. For those of you that don't know, Renee and our team one and team three are using similar methods. A crepe is a thinner type pancake, whereas the pancake is more of a cake mixture. There is 20 minutes left on the clock before they have to present to the judges. Tea number three right now is zesting their lemon. A lot of the flavor from 11 comes in the rind. They just want to take the color part. As soon as they get to the pulp, they want to stop because it causes the taste of the lime or the lemon to become bitter. Right now, Zach Tan is making a crepe. He's swirling the thin batter around. This is very traditional. What do you have reducing right now?
It is the red wine.
So you're having a red wine reduction sauce on your dessert as well. Okay. So getting quite a different range of flavors into there. I see she has cut up a banana as well. That is different from the last time we saw group three. Here comes the fun crepe flip. Have to be very delicate with that. And he has made the flip. Janelle will be pureeing or chopping down her frozen peaches with bananas. As Zach said earlier, he's going to use the frozen peaches as an ice to keep the mixture cold instead of adding a watered-down base from the ice cubes. There are 15 minutes left in the competition. Right now, Renee is getting something on his skillet. Well, let's see what he's working on. He got butter down. Obviously, that's where his pancakes are going in there. How's it? They're talking. I should not interrupt. How is it going?
Going great. I mean, we've got all our components pretty much going. It's pretty much down to final minutes, see how it goes. Simple as that.
And the little skillets you have here, is that where your pancake is going to go?
Yep, that's exactly where we're going to cook it. We're cooking it on a non-stick, so it's a lot easier to flip once it's time to flip. And I'm cooking it with butter instead of anything else just with flavor. I don't cook too healthy, so that's why it's
He has added quite a lot of butter into his skillet. He also said they are using a non-stick pan, which helps flip the pancake. And they're caramelized apples, mangoes, and peaches are bubbling away, which is a good sign. Hopefully it doesn't burn. Ha 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 ha. How is your puree going? She just tasted it, by the way.
I think it's pretty good. I'm just going to adjust it a little bit. I added mascarpone cheese for a little bit of creaminess and a little tang.
All right. It's quite a lovely color right there. Both teams are getting their flour-based component to their dessert cooking away. They don't want to get it down too close to the wire, which they do have just over 10 minutes before they have to present to the judges. Amanda right now is stirring or whisking her caramelized apples and peaches. Renee is flipping his pancakes. Again, the students who are competing in this competition are either in the hospitality or culinology programs. Renee has a question, yes?
Can I have one more of these plates?
Yes, you may. I have to go find Renee a plate. As I was saying, the students who are competing in this competition are either in the hospitality management or major field or culinology field. Right now we have about 120 students in both of those majors. Professor Samir says it's about 50-50 ratio between the majors. For those of you that don't know, hospitality has three concentrations, one in hotel management, one in restaurant management, and another in the culinary arts. And then culinology is defined as the balance between food science and the culinary skills. The students who have graduated from SMSU and the culinology program have found themselves in either General Mills or other Blue Bunny, other companies like that, working in the R&D kitchens or the research and development kitchens. The time is just under 10 minutes for plating. You have about 7 minutes to be exact. The judges have come in again and are watching them to see sanitation. Sanitation is a big issue, as we talked about before. Many, many times we have seen both teams washing their hands. Janelle is working on her butter. I think it's butter. No, it's mascarpone cheese. She is rolling it to make a decorative design. Amanda is thinking about what she wants to do next. As we see right now, Renee is sanitizing something, his plates. He's sanitizing his plates so that he knows that they are clean before he gives them to the judges. Zach is making a, what are you making, Zach?
Cream. So I'm making a whipped cream to fold with the pumpkin and also banana and mango peach puree to make it much more thicker so that we can put on the crepe.
All right. So he's just going to whip up some heavy whipping cream and then fold it into his puree that he made with all of the fruit. There are about 4 minutes left of the competition. 4 minutes left to plate. 4 minutes left before judging starts. We saw the folding of the filling for team number three. How is it going?
Really good. We're just plating up.
Really good. Just plating up. If you guys didn't hear that. Team number one is also plating up. They switched from a square plate to a round plate. I think that they wanted to go with the round flavor or the round plate to go with the pancake. They have just under 3 minutes now. You can feel the tension as they are plating up. Team number one is plating up their pancake, and it seems like they also made a whipped cream to go on top. Team number three is about complete with their dessert. They have a minute right now to finish up. It looks like they will probably finish before time has run out. Time is up, and it's time to go see what the judges think of their last dish, the dessert round. The desserts have been placed in front of the judges. We will start with team number one as they describe their dish to us. Would you mind describing your dish? in the microphone? Can you talk in the microphone, please? Alrighty.
So we got butternut squash pancake, apple, mango, peach, caramel sauce, and then cream cheese, yogurt, clove, then the mustard kind of topping, and then toasted pecans.
So can you tell us where the pepperdew mustard from Silver Spring Foods is located in your dish?
In with the topping, it's in with the cream cheese, heavy cream, some clove, and some lemon juice and honey.
All right, thank you. Will team number three describe their last dish for us, please?
Okay, tonight we've made a crepe filled with a banana peach butternut squash cream with a little bit of mascarpone cheese, and then mango mint mixture with the pepperdew mustard. And it's an inspiration from Papa de Chao restaurant in Brazil, where they have similar papaya cream.
All right. And you did mention, but can you say again where the pepperdew mustard is located in your dish?
We mixed it with the mango and mint, and then we put it in with, folded in with our cream in the crepe.
So it's in the filling. All right. Thank you very much. And you guys can go clean up now, and we'll follow up with you soon. Right? The. Hi, I'm at the prize table right now. So the two teams are competing for a prize. Silver Spring Foods brought a basket here filled with potting soil, potting plants, and also seeds to make your own garden. of herbs, which is very nice for us who like to cook and have organic herbs. And then also for first place, we have two $25 gift cards for their Visa cards, so you can use them wherever you want, Walmart, any place that you might need extra cash for. And then for second prize, Silver Spring Foods also brought water bottles and meat thermometers. And for second place, they'll also be competing for a $10 gift certificate to Applebee's. I'm here with the judges right now, and they have just gone through both of the desserts, and we're going to let them talk about what they liked and what they didn't like about each dish.
Overall, I really enjoyed both desserts. Actually, it's something I would probably order in a restaurant, and I'm not a really big sweet person. I really like the pancake. Really interesting, novel concept. Liked it. The only thing is, I think your pancake was a little tough. And, you know, when I tried your caramel sauce by itself and the cream by itself, I wasn't really impressed. But when I took a bite with everything, oh, my God, it worked well together. You guys did a great job on that. The crepe is something I really liked it. I thought it was a perfect ending. It was nice and light. It had really good balance, a little bit of acidity. You know, it's not going to sit heavy in my stomach. The only criticism I think I would have on the crepe would be that little bit of cream that you had on top. It tasted a little cheesy to me. I don't know if it was supposed to be that way. If it was whipped cream, I would have liked it with a little bit of sugar, maybe sweeten it up a little bit more. It would have tied in nicely. And actually, with both of the desserts, really didn't get the peppadew coming through. I was hoping to get a little bit more of that spicy, sweet heat that you get off of a peppadew. Thought it would have been interesting. But overall, really good.
Very good job on the desserts. For the butternut squash pancake, my pancake was good. I thought it was cooked fine. I could taste the peppadew for sure, and I loved it in this the cream. It was really good, and I thought that it balanced out the syrup and the pancake really well. It was really good. For team three, you did a good job as well. I could not taste the peppadew as much though, and for me, the mint kind of overpowered the dessert, because after I tasted it and then having it in the inside too, I couldn't really get the flavor of the peppadew coming out in there so much, but it still had good flavor. The fresh fruit was a nice touch to that as well, and good job. Thank you.
Okay, team one, I also think this round was the better round of the two that I was here for. The pancake was excellent. I really enjoyed the cream on top as well. It really broke through a lot of the sweetness that you had going on there. I was a little worried at first when I seen how much sauce was on it. I thought it was going to be really sweet, but it actually balanced out fairly well. The only thing, I think maybe a little fresh fruit would have helped bring a little more acidity, a little more balance to it, but it was very good. Team three, I really enjoyed your crepe. I think you could have brought the peppadew through more if you would have just put more of the fruit mixture in there that had it on it. I also wasn't crazy about the, I think it was mascarpone on top and not whipped cream, but it didn't really do a lot for me. It needed some kind of depth or purpose other than to just be on top. The mint didn't bother me as much, but I think just the fruit to cream ratio could have been a little bit heavier on the fruit, and I think the flavor would have came through more.
And the judges have decided who the winner of Chopped Silver Springs Edition 2013 is, and the people who win is Team One, or Renee and Amanda's team. Please, please claim your prizes and show them off. You get a bag from Silver Spring Foods. It has herbs in it, and then you also get a $25 gift card. Mm-hmm. And then Team 3, come take your prize as well. And just again, they get a $10 gift certificate to Applebee's, a water bottle from Silver Spring Foods, and a meat thermometer. Anything else you want to say from the winners? What would you like to say at the end?
Thanks for the competition. I mean, it was a lot of fun competing. We thought we've never done anything like this. So it's brand new to us, and it's pretty sweet to win.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Thank you so much for the opportunity. So.
And we're looking forward to next year.
Picture with the sponsor. I would also like to say thank you to our judges, Professor Samir and Ben Zirpel from Schwann's Food Company, as well as Amber from Silver Spring Foods, and Director Michael Chang for helping organize the entire competition, along with my LLPA, Katie Langle. And I hope you all enjoyed Chopped Silver Spring Foods Edition 2013.